I am Kate with RGG EDU, and I'm going to show you how to install and run the Frontier Action. So if you're unfamiliar with actions in Photoshop, there are a couple ways we can open our actions panel. One is to hit this play button here, and the actions panel will pop out. Or alternatively, we can go to our window tab, scroll down to actions, and it will open the actions panel. Now you'll see there's nothing on the actions panel right now because we haven't loaded the actions. We're gonna go to our tab up here, scroll down to load actions, and you'll see that I've got my actions saved in a folder on my desktop. If you've just downloaded the files, they'll be in your downloads folder. So I'm going to go in here and I'm going to select my Frontier action and hit open. And you'll now see that they're loaded into the actions panel. And we can expand our set and hit the Frontier. This is the actual action. And to play it, we'll just hit this little play button down here. And now we've loaded our action. Let's take a look at our Frontier action and see how it's going to affect our image. So I'm going to turn this off for a second. This is our before. And this is with our action on. It's warming up the neutrals and the warm tones, bringing in kind of an orangey-yellow undertone. And then it's bringing cyans into the highlights. So let's delve a little bit deeper and kind of go into our actual action and see what's happening here. You'll notice that we've got a bunch of different layers here. And I've tried to name each of the layers according to the function. So the nice part about this is, even if you're not super familiar with certain functions in Photoshop, like say you're not super comfortable with curves, that's okay. You'll be able to identify with the description here what's actually happening. And we can toggle it on and off. We can also adjust the opacity. So this gives us a little bit more flexibility in terms of how we want to affect the image. And it also makes it so that you don't have to add your own additional layers on top of this. If there's something already here, we can adjust. We can just break down the layer, turn it on or off, or adjust it according to the image. This particular image here is already a little bit warmer, but it also looks really nice on something a bit cooler with some blue tones in the sky, like this image of our farmer here. If we run this action, and here's where we really see that sort of cinematic effect. So we'll see these kind of brown tones come into the skin, and then the sky goes from more of a cooler blue to something a little bit more cyan. We're also bringing down the luminosity of the highlights as well and bringing up our shadows just a bit. This particular action gets a little bit tricky when you're starting with an image that already has a lot of warm tones in it, so something shot at golden hour might not be as effective. So we really want to stick to images like this that already are starting in that kind of neutral color temperature territory. It's really nice for something like this, again, sort of a neutral palette. And if we run this, it really just makes that fall effect pop. It gives it that nice cinematic quality. So if that's the sort of aesthetic that you're going for, this is a really powerful action.